I see two little hyenas. Now, it doesn't look like the adults are here, so we'll only stay for a little bit and then we're gonna have to move out. Let me just pull off to the side. Let me go a little bit further forward, Craig, so you can see the youngest one, the youngest hyena cub, just sitting to the left of Ntima. Oh, they're looking so tired. They must be enjoying the last of the afternoon sun. Oh, okay. Normally it's the other way around. Normally it's the youngest cub that climbs on the oldest one, for looking for comfort. And it seems as though the older one's just going to flop over the top of it. But isn't that so sweet? Very peaceful scene. Now I wonder where the adults are, because the last couple of times I've popped in, I haven't seen them around. Perhaps they're busy elsewhere, swatting flies. There's lots of flies out today, I suppose because it's nice and hot. And they don't seem to be interested in us at all this afternoon. Well, not yet. Maybe at some point. Go away, fly. Get out of here. You've got the entire, the whole of Africa to fly around. You don't need to fly right next to me. Flies. One of the most annoying things out here. I'm going to have to get a gwari bush today, I reckon. But this is very, very nice, of course, and I'm sure that you're all very happy to see these hyenas. You had a nice sighting with Tristan this morning, I think. Did Tristan have a sighting with hyena? When was that, yesterday? No, that was yesterday, sorry, where the hyena's wanting to bite his tires. Now, Barbara, you've said that you love hyenas. Oh, look at that face. Isn't that so precious? They are so sweet when they're this age, so fluffy. But look at those very droopy eyes. It's almost impossible to keep them open. Now, Tony, you say flat spots, I suppose. Not leopard spots this time, but hyena spots, laying as flat as they can be down on the ground. They've obviously had quite a busy day. And it looks like they've brought a couple of things up to the den to chew. Craig, can we have a closer look at that thing on the right? That white thing. Is it a bone? Does it look like a bone? Does it look like... I actually don't know what that is. Part of it, or is it a log? It's difficult to tell what that actually is. Maybe part of a buffalo skull? The horns, maybe? And then that part is the actual skull? I don't actually know. There's lots. Just the reason why I'm thinking that is before the, from that coloration. And then I also know how many buffalo the Nkuhumas took down in this area. So it's definitely a possibility. But I'm glad that they're resting and not paying too much attention to us today. They are very inquisitive normally, as you've seen over the last couple of times, and they can be quite destructive. What? Destructive? I think I just made up a word there. Destructive. I don't even know what that means. Sorry, I meant to say destructive. Oh my goodness. Now, Alice, sorry, can I have that question again? I was obviously laughing at myself and I couldn't hear your voice over the sound of my noisy voice. Now, it's a question from Rachel, and it's, why are the hyena cubs outside of the den if the adults are not around? Well, they do have freedom to sort of move around within the den. They're obviously told by the adults, you stay put, you're not allowed to leave the house. They're basically under house arrest, if you think about it. They can't go anywhere. But at least they've got a nice home to live in. So they will come out, they'll play, they'll chew on things, they'll walk around a little bit. It's not uncommon for them to go and wander. We see them, they come right up to the cars sometimes and smell the tires and all those types of things. Sometimes chew on the tires too, which we don't want them to do. But it's not a problem that they're outside the den. And that's why we don't want to stay here for too long. So I'm actually going to move out now because the adults are not around here. And it's not fair on them to not have parental guidance in case something goes wrong. Right, let's reverse now. Hello, Carsten.